In this tutorial, we are going to take a look at bend constraints. Each bend constraint affects three particles. It tries to keep them in a straight line. When they deviate from this configuration, it applies forces to the three of them to try and get them back in line. Usually, bend constraints are more useful when chaining together multiple particles. This means a single bend constraint can share up to two particles with another bend constraint. In this real-world example, we have a chain of bend constraints, the way they are set up by OB rope. As you can see, they make the rope quite rigid. If we deactivate them, particles will no longer try to form a straight line. As a result, the rope will bend much more easily. Enabling them again yields the initial rigid chain. It is possible to control the rigidness of a chain of bend constraints by using the max bending parameter. Higher values will cause the constraints to tolerate a certain degree of deviation from a straight line before taking action. Bend constraints also allow us to control the orientation of a group of particles. This is useful to make a rope stick out of a surface. By fixing a couple particles, the bend constraints will propagate the orientation of the line between them along the rope. Fix just one particle, however, and the rope will freely rotate around it, similar to a hinge. This is because particles in OB are just positions in space, they do not encode rotation or scale.